Welcome to everyone. Freedom struggle in Tamil Nadu. So this all we already discussed in previous lesson, Gandhian pass. What we learned in Gandhian pass in India, same they given in this lesson in Tamil Nadu. So what happened in India, same they given in Tamil Nadu. For example, non-cooperation movement, no tax campaign, civil disobedience. So this all happened in Gandhian pass in India. Same they given it. It was spread in Tamil Nadu. Okay, so both 8th and 9th lesson, just you can read, compare, and you can learn. It is very easy to learn. And this lesson, non-cooperation movement. So what is non-cooperation movement? After the introduction of the Rowlatt Act. Okay, now well, what is Rowlatt Act? Without any warrant, suddenly they can arrest our Indian people and Indian leader. Is called as Rowlatt Act. It was introduced by Rowlatt in 1919. Okay. And next one is Jallianwala Bagh massacre. So after this incident, Gandhiji introduced non-cooperation movement in 1920. Okay. Gandhi introduced non-cooperation movement in 1920. So what is non-cooperation movement? We should not accept the British government rule, is called as non-cooperation. We should surrender the certificate to the British government and boycott the British goods and given the importance of Indian goods. So these are examples for this non-cooperation movement. Okay. So it is led by Mahatma Gandhi and this non-cooperation movement is spread in Tamil Nadu. Okay, it was spread in Tamil Nadu, Rajaji and the Muslim League, both also, they got the mutual understand and spread in Tamil Nadu. Okay. Next one is no tax and temperance movement. So, no tax. So, our Indian people start paying tax to the British government. So, started the campaign is called as no tax campaign. So, in this no tax campaign, they accepted, should not pay the tax to the British government, boycott the British goods. So these are no tax campaign. The no tax campaign. And next one is temperance movement. Temperance means liquid alcohol. So it's called as temperance movement. So our Indian people against this alcohol. So they started the movement. Against the alcohol, they started the movement. It's called as temperance movement. Next one is Swarajist and Justice Party. So Swarajist means is one of the party. Okay. Political party. So Swarajist means self-rule. What is the meaning? Means self-rule. Okay. Swarajist Party. So this no tax campaign in 1922. Okay. 1922. Chowri Chowka incident. Chowri Chowka incident. What happened means our youngster, they fired the police station and they killed 22 policemen. Okay, 1922. So that Mahatma Gandhi withdrew the non-cooperation movement in 1922. Chowra Chowri incident, they killed 22 policemen. So that they withdrew the non-cooperation movement during this no-tax campaign. So that next they started the Swarajist parties. Swarajist parties. Since this withdrawal the no cooperation movement, they started among Indian Congress two divided. They started two division. One is pro changes. Another one is no changes. So what is pro changes? So pro changes means they expected the changes. Okay. Because they withdrew the non-cooperation movement so that Das and Nehru accepted the pro-changes. Pro-changes means our India also should participate in the legislative assembly. From that legislative assembly, they are trying to bring some changes. So it's called as pro-changes. No changes means Rajaji, Vallabhbhai Patel, so they all accepted their no changes. No changes means they accepted only the non-cooperation movement. They against withdraw this non-cooperation movement. Accepted the non-cooperation movement. Only the non-violence, we should get the freedom. They accepted this no changes. So among Congress committee divided into no pro changes and no changes. Okay. So then they started the Swarajist. Swarajist means self rule. Okay, Fascist means self rule. Self rule. So they started the processes, Fascist and Justice Rivalry. Both also they started the problem. Rivalry is Fascist political party and the Justice. Both also started the rivalry because of this pro changes and no changes. Pro changes and no changes. So Swarajist is the political parties and Justice is also is the political parties become the rivalry between pro changes and no changes. So Swarajist party, okay. So Swarajist party became one most of the territories during the Legislative Assembly. Okay, they got more seat in the Legislative Assembly. But Congress committee supported the independent candidate Subbarayan. Supported the independent candidate Subbarayan. So that Subbarayan became the minister in 1926. Okay, in the 1926 election, Swarajist became one more seat. But Indian Congress supported the independent candidate Subbarayan. So Subbarayan became the minister in 1926. So that in 1930, the Swarajist boycott the election, Legislative Assembly election. 1930, Swarajist boycott the election. So that without any competition, Justice Cities became the ruler and they ruled up to 1937. Because no competition, they boycott the election in 1930. Okay, Swarajist boycott the election in 1930. So that Justice Cities became the Legislative Assembly again up to 1930 to 1937. Next one is Simon Commission. So Simon Commission, because of Indian Act 1919, the British appointed Sir John Simon. Okay, Sir John Simon to solve the problem with India Act 1919. So in the Simon Commission, mostly everyone all white person. So they appointed only the British Commission, okay, only the British people, so that our Indian people, Mahatma Gandhi, not accepted this Simon Commission in 1927, because in this commission, the members are everyone British, so that we cannot get good solution, so that they not accepted this Simon Commission, okay. So this is how we learned in our previous lesson, yes or no? So Swarajist, Simon Commission, no tax, no cooperation movement, born as Swaraj. So this is how we learned in previous class. Okay. So next one is civil disobedience movement. Civil means within the country. Okay. With inside the country is called as civil. So disobedience movement. Obedience now you don't accept the civil law. Okay. So British civil law. So it is called as civil disobedience movement. So they started the Purna Swaraj. Purna Swaraj means self-government. Okay. Purna Swaraj means self-government, self-rule. So in 1929, the Lahore Committee, in Lahore they accepted to celebrate the Purna Swaraj. So that the next year, 1930, 26 January, the Indian National Congress declared the Purna Swaraj in 1930, 26 January. So to remember in this day, 26 January, at present we are celebrating the Republic Day. Okay, actually Republic Day, the constitution is completed 26 November, but it was came into effect 26 January because of remember this day 26 January. So we are celebrating the Republic Day. Okay, so it is towards Purna Swaraj. Purna Swaraj means complete independence. Next one is Salt March to Weather Niyam. So they started the Salt Satyagraha in Tamil Nadu also. It is written Thandi Yatre. Okay, so Thandi Yatre, Mahatma Gandhi led in North India. In Tamil Nadu also spread this Salt Satyagraha. Salt Satyagraha. So Rajaji, EVR all participated in this Salt Satyagraha. They started the march from Tiruchirappalli to Vedaniyam. Okay, Tiruchirappalli to Vedaniyam. Trichy to Vedaniyam. Okay, Trichy to Vedaniyam for this Salt Satyagraha. So in this time the British police they arrested our Indian leader and put in the jail during this Salt March to Vedaniyam. Aranyam. They collected many members ready to participate in this Salt to Satyagraha in Tamil Nadu, but nearly they collected only 100 members and started march Tiruchi to Vedaniyam. Okay, Tiruchi to Vedaniyam. Next one is widespread agitation. So this agitation, this problem spread in most of the place in Tamil Nadu. Most of the place in Tamil Nadu, women, children, school students, college students, so most of them they participated in this agitations. Okay, so during this Salt March Vedaniyam, Namakkal Kavinger Ramalingam sung the inspiration song without sword, without blood, they started the march. Okay, so Namakkal Kavinger Ramalingam. Namakkal poet Ramalingana sung the song without a sword, without a blood, he started the march. Okay, during this Salt Satyagraha from Tiruchi to Vedaniyam. Next one is this widespread agitation. Most of them they participated in the agitation. Women, the first woman. Okay, so the first woman paid the penalty for this Salt Satyagraha is Rukmani Lakshmibari. Rukmani Lakshmibari. Rukmani Lakshmibari is the first woman pay the penalty for this participated in the Salt Satyagraha in Tamil Nadu. Next one is Tirupur Kumaran. So Tirupur Kumaran popularly called as Kodigatha Kumaran. Kodigatha Kumaran, during this agitation, British police brutally attacked the Indian people. Since that time they attacked the Tirupur Kumaran, just he fall down, while falling down, he did not put the flag down, okay. Holding the flag, he died. Kumaran, Tirupur Kumaran, he died. So, he popularly called as Kodigatha Kumaran. Okay, called as Kodigatha Kumaran. Kodigatha. Okay, so while attacking the British, while falling down, he did not left the flag. Okay, did not left the flag, just holding the flag, he died. So, he called as Kodigatha Kumaran. And next one is First Congress Ministry. So this First Congress Ministry started in 1937. So most of the Legislative Assembly they won and became the Congress. Congress became the ruler in India. In that time we can understand among the people they got good name for this Indian National Congress. So the first time they are assigned in 1937, Ministry, Indian National Congress formed the Ministry in 1937. But the Second World War 1939, without getting the knowledge of Congress Ministry, the British government participated in the Second World War. Okay, so without support of Indian National Congress, they participated in the Second World War. So that Indian National Congress resigned the ministry. Okay, so because British government participated in the Second World War, so that Indian National Congress resigned the ministry. They formed the ministry in 1937. So that they resigned the ministry. Okay, next one is anti-Hindi agitation. So the leader of the Indian National Congress is Rajaji. So under the Rajaji, they formed the ministry. Under the Rajaji formed the ministry. So in that time, he declared Hindi is the compulsory language for all the school in India. All the school Hindi is the compulsory languages. So that our Tamil Nadu ruler EVR Rajaji, EVR, okay, Ramasamy, so most of them they not accepted the Hindi is the compulsory language in Tamil Nadu. So that they started the agitation in Salem. Okay. So the against the Rajaji Indian National Congress was Hindi agitation. Okay, against the Hindi agitation started in Salem. One of the main performers EVR Ramasamy. Okay, popularly called as Periyar. Just he started the agitation in Salem against Hindi. But in that time, Indian National Congress resigned because of British government participated in the Second World War. So they resigned. So that the Madras Council, the British Madras Council abolished the Hindi language is compulsory for the called the school. Okay, because Indian National Congress resigned, so that Madras Council, okay, British Madras Council abolished the English the compulsory language for all the school. Okay, next one was Quiet India Struggle. Quiet India Struggle. Okay, so in this 8th August 1942, in this year the resolution was passed and Gandhi gave do or die. So Mahatma Gandhi used to fight India struggle, do or die. Okay, do or die. Okay, so in this do or die, the concept is we should get the freedom or else we should die. So this is the concept of this do or die, the Quiet India Struggle. Quiet India means white person, British government should go to their native place. It's called as Quiet India Struggle. It was started Mahatma Gandhi 8th August 1942. The important word of this Quiet India Struggle, do or die. Okay, do or die. Do or die. So that most of the many persons participated in this Quiet India Struggle. But next day, 9th August 1942, the British tried to arrest all the Indian National Congress members. Just saw the Kamarajar escaped from arrest from British government, and started the underground operation and led the Quiet India Struggle. Okay, Kamarajar escaped to arrest British police and led the underground operation, led the Quiet India Struggle. Okay, Quiet India Struggle. Next one is Undying Mass Movement. So this mass movement, all the religion, all the caste, Hindu, Muslim, all the one, they participated in this mass movement. Okay, they participated in this mass movement and they fight against the British government. So after the changes of the London Labour Party became the Prime Minister. The political has changed in London, so that the British government ready to accept the freedom in India. But on sad news, after this freedom, India is divided into two countries. One is Pakistan, another one is India. Okay, another one is India. So that the British government declared war neighboring countries, which territories, if they wish, they can go to the Pakistan or else they should join in India. Okay, so that 15th August, finally the Labour Party gave the freedom for India. 15th August 1947 got the freedom, and Pakistan got 14th August 1947. Okay, one day before they got the freedom, but 15 August we got the freedom in India. Okay. Next, learn and write the following. The question is, describe the role in Tamil Nadu in the civil disobedience movement. Next one, explain about Quiet India Struggle. Next question is, write in detail about non-cooperation movement. So this all we learned in previous lesson, Gandhian Pass. Okay, so just compare the lesson, history 8th and 9th lesson. It is very easy to learn. Okay. So I hope you understood this session very well. Read well. Thank you. Have a nice day.